Hi, I'm Rick for TGW.com, and this is the new G425 hybrid from Ping. I got to hit these hybrids this week for the first time. I'm going to try to give you an idea of who might want to try the new G425 hybrids. I'll talk about my experiences when hitting them for the first time, talk about the look, feel, and the sound, and then, of course, I'll go over the ball data. What type of shots did I hit with the new G425 hybrids? Listed are the standard specifications on the G425 hybrids, and you can see that there are 6 different loft options available. But remember, each one of the G425 hybrids can be adjusted in loft up to plus or minus 1.5 degrees for you to really fine-tune the distance that you're looking for. I hit the 19 degree 3 hybrid. Ping is offering the Alta CB Slate 70 or the Alta Distanza Black 40 as stock graphite shaft options, but they also have several no-charge graphite shaft options. I got to hit with the Ping Tour 85 Stiff Flex Graphite. Ping is using the Arcos Caddy Smart Grip. It's a Golf Pride Light 360 Tour Velvet available in 4 different sizes. But remember, TGW.com can accommodate any custom requests. With an extremely high MOI, great performance, a ton of adjustability, and a lot of loft offerings, I'm not sure who wouldn't want to try the new G425 hybrids. The look of the G425 hybrid is very clean. At address, I love the flat black finish. I feel like the ball really stands out. Ping is using a new 3-dot alignment system, which I also like. At impact, the clubs felt very solid, and I was very pleased with the trajectory of the shots I hit. I tested the G425 hybrids this week for the first time, and again, I hit the 19 degree 3 hybrid, and this club did exactly what I would hope it would do. I was swinging at just under 90 miles an hour on average, getting a nice ball speed of 131 miles an hour, launching the 19 degree at just under 16 degrees. I was getting a spin rate of 3,500 RPMs and a max height of 96 feet elevation. My descent angle was 43.7, and that's really good because that is shallow enough to where on a fairway my ball is going to hit and release, but it's steep enough to where if I'm hitting this club into a green, it's going to hit and hold. Average carry distance with the 3 hybrid for me was right at 201 yards. Let's talk about the technology that Ping is using with the new G425 hybrids and start with the multi-material construction. The body of the hybrids is made of a 17-4 stainless steel. It's got a miraging steel face with face wrap technology. Typically where the face stops at the crown, Ping is actually wrapping the face onto the crown, which allows for more face flexing, and more face flexing creates more ball speed, which creates better distance. Next is a new term Ping is labeled as spinsistency, and that is an effort to get the same amount of backspin on all shots regardless of where they're hit vertically on the face. Typically, a shot hit low on the face is going to have an increase in ball spin, and a shot hit high on the face is going to have a decrease in backspin, and both of those are going to have an inconsistent outcome on your distance. Ping has changed the curvature, the vertical roll of the face on the hybrids, to lessen the variance on backspin for improved distance control. If improved, more consistent distances with your hybrids sounds like it would help you play better golf, remember, TGW.com has you covered should you want to try a G425 hybrid. They offer a 30-day mulligan buyback on any standard stock order and up to 90 days should you place a custom order. Great new hybrids from Ping. These are the G425. You can check them out. Please check out our other product review videos, all at TGW.com.